It's the night of the senior prom. The Bates High School gym is alive with excitement. Everybody is there, even Carrie White, the girl no one likes.
We're all sorry about this incident, Cassie.
It's Carrie!
And everyone makes fun of her. The girl who lives in that creepy house with her crazy mother.
Help the sinning woman see the sin of her days and ways. Show her that if she had remained sinless, the curse of blood would never have come on her.
The girl with the strange power.
If I concentrate hard enough, I can move things.
But tonight, no one will laugh at Carrie.
You don't have a date for the prom next Friday. Would you like to go with me?
She's with the best-looking boy in the senior class.
He's trying to trick me again.
She'll be voted queen of the prom.
You know, I can make sure that you don't hurt Carrie White anymore. Yay!
For Carrie, it will be a dream come true. For everyone else, it will be a nightmare. Carrie. A new film by Brian De Palma. Based on the chilling bestseller. Starring Sissy Spacek, Piper Laurie, and introducing John Travolta in his first motion picture role. If you have a taste for terror, you have a date with Carrie.
I don't suppose they told you anything in Denver about the tragedy we had up here during the winter of 1970? Well, a man named Charles Grady is the winter caretaker. And he came up here with his wife and two little girls, I think about 8 and 10. From what I've been told, I mean, he seemed like a completely normal individual. But at some point during the winter, he must have suffered some kind of a complete mental breakdown. He ran amok and killed his family with an axe.
You can rest assured, Mr. Ullman, that's not going to happen with me.
Mom?
Yeah?
Do you really want to go and live in that hotel for the winter?
Sure I do. It'll be lots of fun.
Yeah, I guess so.
For some people, solitude and isolation can of itself become a problem.
What do you do? They killed you and Danny.
You did this to me.
Soon. Jolting tales of horror. Creepshow. From the author of Carrie, The Shining, and Cujo. And the creator of Night of the Living Dead and Dawn of the Dead. You'll scream at ghastly ghouls. Cringe at weird kids and shiver at the doings of evil doctors.
This is going to be extremely painful.
painful, Mr. Verrill.
Creepshow will grab you, grow on you, and give you the creeps.
No, this is going to be an entirely new experience.
Creepshow, the most fun you'll ever have being scared.
Charlie McGee is a happy, healthy little 8-year-old girl. Normal in every way, but one.
Well, what is it you really want?
That my involvement with this child, Charlene, will not end by my bringing her here. No, no, it's just the beginning.
Charlie has the power. She can set things on fire with just a glance.
Do something bad? Will you still love me?
Oh, Charlie. She's very beautiful. She's very young. Yet inside her is the power of the gods.
It is a power she does not want. A power she cannot control.
We haven't got it yet.
We'll have her.
Show me a warrant or get the hell off my land.
We don't need a warrant.
And each night she prays to be just like every other child. But there are those who will do everything in their power to find her, to control her.
We're going to be close, she and I. Oh, yes. We're going to be very close.
And maybe to destroy her.
You're going to have to burn it down, honey. Burn it all down.
Charlie McGee is Stephen King's Firestarter. David Keith, Freddie Jones, Heather Locklear, Martin Sheen, George C. Scott, Art Carney, Louise Fletcher, and Drew Barrymore as Stephen King's Firestarter. Firestarter, will she have the power to survive?
Nothing that lives in the imagination is more frightening than the terror that lives in Castle Rock, Maine.
Cujo?
Cujo?
Can he get us in here?
God, I'm losing my baby.
From the novel by Stephen King, creator of Carrie and The Shining, comes a startling vision of fear.
Please, God, get me out of here.
Now there's a new name for terror. Cujo.
If the future were in your hands,
screaming. The house is burning.
Would you change it?
Hurry up! It's not too late.
Touch this man's hand, and you are in the grip of the dead zone.
I've had another episode.
Only the imagination of author Stephen King could take you there.
Johnny, wait.
With a power that alters the future lives of those you love.
You want to kill your own son?
I want you out of here.
I'm scared, Dad.
Or of those you fear.
I have had a vision that I am going to be president of the United States someday, and nobody,
I mean nobody,
gonna stop me.
Is it a power for good or for evil?
If God has seen fit to bless you with this gift, you should use it.
Bless me?
You're a devil. Send for me.
Who are you?
Who sent you?
I'm scared, sir.
What's happening to me? We're gonna get married, Johnny. Don't leave me, please.
Didn't you see how clear it all is? Not only can you see the future,
I can change it.
Skeleton!
I was there, I saw it.
Put your hand on the scanning screen and you'll go down in history with me.
I saw his face. I stood there. I did nothing.
Johnny!
Stephen King, The Dead Zone. Stephen King, your favorite novelist and master of modern horror, has written his first motion picture screenplay. It combines all the elements of his creative imagination. Lovable pets. Classic cars. Quiet evenings. Favorite films.
Kill the son of it.
Good idea.
Adorable kids.
Help me! It's after me!
And of course, a monster or two. Experience a series of electrifying adventures. As seen through Stephen King's Cat's Eye.
Where's your sense of humor?
Stephen King's Cat's Eye.
I want you to turn this into a silver bullet.
You want a silver bullet, eh? Nicest piece of work I ever done, I think. Ought to be pretty accurate.
Oh, Tech, you're gonna shoot a 44 bullet at anyway. Made out of silver.
How about a werewolf?
You know, Tammy told me she'd been hearing noises in the greenhouse. Growling noises. Father was killed that night.
Listen, Marty. You have got to get this idea out of your head. Psychotics are more active when the moon is full. And this guy's a psycho. When they catch him, you're gonna find out he's just as human as you and me.
I'm a little too old to be playing the Hardy Boys Meet Reverend Werewolf.
It came for me. I shot it in the eye. Now he's wearing an eye patch.
You won't let go of it, will you?
I saw what I saw.
Why don't you guys tell me how this guy Lo became a werewolf?
I don't know. Maybe he doesn't know either. I think he's going to come after me. But I think I'll wait till the moon's all the way full. And there's no Reverend Lo at all. Only the monster.
Yeah.
My name is Stephen King. I've written several motion pictures, but I want to tell you about a movie called Maximum Overdrive, which is the first one I've directed.
Wow. What in the dickens is going on around here?
A lot of people have directed Stephen King novels and stories. And I finally decided if you want something done right, you ought to do it yourself.
And who was driving it?
I don't know.
It was my first picture as a director, and you know something? I sort of enjoyed it.
What is going on?
I don't know!
I just wanted someone to do Stephen King right.
You want a war? You got one.
I just want to get the hell out of here.
So come and spend some time with me and my friends at the Dixie Boy. Spend some time in the dark.
Please don't let us be in the dark.
Help me.
I'm gonna scare the hell out of you. And that's a promise.
You're gonna get us in an awful lot of trouble, man.
We already in trouble.
Maximum Terror.
Jesus coming and he is.
Maximum King.
Maybe tomorrow will be our world again.
Dino De Laurentiis presents Stephen King's Maximum Overdrive.
In all our lives, there's a fall from innocence. A time after which we are never the same. It happened in the summer of 1959. A long time ago.
Not only if you measure it in terms of years.
Guys, wanna go see a dead body?
I bet you anything that if we find him, we'll get our pictures in the paper. Yeah, we can even be on TV. Sure, we'll be heroes. Yeah.
Just suppose that I told the story. Do you think that anyone would have believed it?
This is really a good time.
The most. A blast.
And you and Mr. Crandall buried him.
Why, Judd?
I had my reasons.
What did we do tonight, Judd?
What we did, Lois, was a secret.
But some don't stay.
May the Lord bless you and keep you.
No!
May the Lord make his face to shine upon you.
You're thinking thoughts best not thought of, Lois.
Daddy's gonna do something!
something really bad.
That's why no one ever buried a human being out there.
You're thinking of putting them up there. Don't deny the thought hadn't crossed your mind.
And why nothing ever rests in peace.
If it doesn't work, I'll just put him back to sleep.
Come back to me, Gage. Come back to us.
Paramount Pictures presents Stephen King's all-time best-selling tale of horror.
Gage?
First I play a stud. Mommy, Gage, let's play with Mommy. We had an awful good time.
What did you do?
What did you do?
Pet Cemetery.
Now I'm gonna play with you.
You almost died. You have a compound fracture of the tibia in both legs, and the fibula in the right leg is fractured too. And as soon as the road's open, I'll take you to a hospital. In the meantime, you've got a lot of recovering to do.
There is nothing to worry about. You're gonna be just fine. I'm your number one fan.
My name is Annie Wilkes.
I think one of my clients, Paul Sheldon, might be in some kind of trouble.
You mean Paul Sheldon, the writer?
Well, everybody sure likes those misery books.
They had it at the store, Paul.
They said he checked out last Tuesday. Isn't that a little strange?
I guess it was kind of a miracle you finding me.
In a way, I was following you.
Who followed me?
Oh, Paul, I've read everything of yours, but the misery novels. You must be a good man. You could never have created such a wondrous, loving creature as Misery Chastain.
Very kind.
The presumption must now be that Paul Sheldon is dead.
You dirty bird. How could you? Misery Chastain cannot be dead.
Misery Spirit is still alive.
I don't want her spirit! I want her! And you murdered her!
You don't think he's dead, do you?
And don't even think about anybody coming for you, because I never called them. Nobody knows you're here. And you better hope nothing happens to me. Because if I die, you die. I know you've been out. Is this what you're looking for? Eventually, you'll come to accept the idea of being here.
Annie, whatever you're thinking about doing, please don't do it. Annie, for God's...
Shh, darling. Trust me.
God's sake!
It's for the best. God, I love you.
Charles Brady is new in town.
You can actually talk to him?
Yeah, he's nice.
Real nice.
The girls all like him. The teachers all respect him.
Your teachers in Ohio must have been sorry to lose such a creative young man.
The parents all trust him.
He's utterly charming.
But nobody really knows him. Like his mother.
You cannot be in love with this girl, Charles.
You don't know me, Tanya.
But I want to.
Behind their smile is a secret.
Hi.
Come in, Tanya. I have something for you.
I don't know who you are, but I know you're not who you say you are.
Behind the secret is a hunger.
Does it have to be her?
And behind it all is the imagination of Stephen King.
Killed one of my men.
He was scared of a cat.
Stephen King. Kings, Sleepwalkers.
Did you weigh yourself?
297.
Billy, you were 297 last week.
Well, it takes some time for these diets to work.
For Billy Halleck, life is sweet. Bigger is better. And too much is never enough.
Winning! Winning!
Dear God, stop eating like that.
I can't help it, Heidi. All I think about is food.
But tonight, all of that will change.
You kill my daughter, and I curse you.
Sinner.
From the best-selling novel by Stephen King comes the new shape of terror.
This diet you're on, what is it?
I don't think you'd like it, Henry.
I'm being erased.
Fear the power.
That old gypsy put a curse on me.
It's all your fault if you hadn't hit that old lady.
Beware the danger.
This is getting out of hand.
This has been out of hand, and I'm just the guy to put it back.
Believe the curse.
Please, take it off before this goes any further.
I never take it off.
Stephen King's Thinner. More terror. Less filling.
Sincerely repents on what he'd done wrong, that he might get to go back to the time that was happiest for him and live there forever. But that'd be what heaven's like.
I just about believe that very thing.
John Coffey, you have been condemned to die in the electric chair by a jury of your peers, sentence imposed by a judge in good standing in this state. Questions.
Do you leave the light on after bedtime?
I know violent men. I deal with them day in and day out. There doesn't seem to be any real violence in him.
Until he kills a couple of little girls.
John Coffey is a murderer.
I don't think he did it at all.
Take my hand, both. You see for yourself.
You're talking about a miracle.
I do not see God putting a gift like that in the hands of a man who would kill a child.
I dreamed of you. We found each other in the dark.
Like you dropped out of the sky.
Miracles are funny things. You never know when they're going to happen. And when they happen in a place like this, that's the most unbelievable miracle of all. This is the story of a miracle that happened here where I work, on the Green Mile.
There are those who believe your dreams have great power. And to remain safe, you must sleep beneath a dream catcher. The legend says, pleasant dreams
pass through the center. While nightmares become entangled in its web. This time, evil slips through.
My guess is it's a crash landing.
They're up to their old tricks.
I'll tell you what you should be worried about. A hitchhiker. That's been our greatest fear. Somebody who could pass for one of us.
You're not Jonesy.
These are Americans. The idea of slaughtering Americans just turns my stomach.
Come with me, Owen. I'll show you things you wish you'd never seen.
Say your departs.
Why don't you get Billy dressed? I'll take him into town with him. Hit the store before it gets all bought out.
How'd you folks hold up in the storm?
Big insurance day.
Sorry to hear that.
What's going on?
It's death.
Shut the doors! Shut the doors!
The only way we're gonna help ourselves is to seek rescue.
Tie this around your waist?
For four.
It'll let us know you got at least 300 feet.
There's nothing out there. Nothing in the mist.
What if you're wrong?
Then I guess the joke would be on me.
It is time to take sides. Read the good book. It calls for blood.
Guys, I hear something.
Are those bugs?
Not like any I've ever seen.
The entire front of this door is plate glass.
I thought that there were other dimensions. They wanted to try and make a window.
Well, maybe your window turned out to be a door.
Who she's gonna sacrifice to make it all better?
We want the boy.
You try it.
Kill him!
His daughter. The afterlife became his obsession.
You probably want to hear all about our haunted history.
But after years of searching, he no longer believes.
So you're saying there's no such thing as ghosts?
I'm saying I've never seen one. Nothing would make me happier than to experience a paranormal event.
Gerald.
Harold Olin, manager of the Dolphin.
I can just get the key to 1408.
In the 95 years of the hotel's existence, there have been 56 deaths in 1408.
56?
No one's ever lasted more than an hour. The first victims to Kevin O'Malley.
Cut his own throat.
Do not stay in that room.
This is it. Hotel rooms are a naturally creepy place. It does have the vague air of menace. Nobody lasts more than an hour.
You're gonna have to try harder, Olin!
It's not that what I'm seeing is not real. It just ain't as real as it seems.
Darkness. For thousands of generations, the gunslingers were knights sworn to protect it. Now I'm the only one left.
The tower will fall.
Get used to the carnage.
Now the war's come to Earth.
Do you really think you can stop me, gunslinger? Everyone who walks with you dies. No more.
I do not shoot with my hand.
I shoot with my mind.
I do not kill with my gun. I kill with my heart.
There you go. She's all ready, Captain.
Thanks, Billy.
People die or disappear 6 times the national average. And that's just grown-ups. Kids are worse. Way, way worse.
We all float down here.
I saw something. There was this...
clown. Yeah, I saw him too.
It's all connected by the sewers. That's where it lives. What happened?
Killed.
You'll float too. 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 You'll float too.
Something happens to you when you leave this town. The farther away, the hazier it all gets. But me, I never left. I remember all of it. We made an oath.
Swear? If it isn't dead, if it ever comes back, we'll come back to you.
We didn't stop it.
Pennywise.
The clown.
We can't let it happen again.
Hello?
Kate!
Magic, like me.
I need you to listen to me. The world's a hungry place. A dark place.
Hi there.
I only met two or three people like us. They died. When I was a kid, I bumped into these things. Magic. I always called it the Shining.